how to calculate the least count of the spectrometer. So when you peeped inside the vernier, you saw two scales. One was the main scale and second was the vernier scale. Just here you can see I have drawn, this is the black line is indicating the main scale. This main scale means that this circular scale is comprised of an angle of total of 360 degrees. So I have shown you a gradation from 70 degree to 100 degree, and between 70 degree to 80 degree there are 20 divisions. You can see one small big, and here likewise there are 20 divisions between the 10 degrees. And the vernier that I am showing here is consisting of 60 divisions. So what we always find in a vernier caliper, that how many there are vernier scale divisions in a particular vernier scale, it will always coincide with one less number of the main scale division. Means if there are vernier scale of 60 divisions here, so it is so designed that it will coincide with 59 main scale divisions. As you are seeing here, that this zero of the vernier is coinciding with the 70 degree of the main scale, and there are 20 divisions in between. So, and the total here are 60 vernier scale divisions. So the last 60th is coinciding with the 59th division, 20, 40 and 19. So that makes a total of 59 divisions. So 60 vernier scale divisions is coinciding with 59 main scale divisions. So whenever we choose a spectrometer, always see how many vernier divisions are there. If there is a vernier that is having 30 vernier scale divisions, so 30 vernier scale divisions will be coinciding with 29 main scale divisions. Always one number less. If there are 40 vernier scale divisions in the spectrometer, so it would coincide with 39 main scale divisions. And you must be remembering also of the vernier calipers. So the vernier caliper consisted of 10 vernier scale divisions. So 10 vernier scale divisions coincided with 9 main scale divisions. So always remember that how many number of vernier divisions are there, it will always coincide with one less number of the main scale division. So 60 vernier scale division is coinciding with 59 main scale divisions. So one vernier scale division will be equal to 59 by 60 main scale division. Now when we want to calculate the least count, so least count is always the difference of the main scale division and one vernier scale division. So least count is given by 1 MST minus 1 VST. And here we have calculated our 1 VST to be equal to 59 by 60 MST. So 1 MST minus 59 by 60 MST. MSD, MST is common, so you get 1 minus 59 by 60 MST. So it comes out to be 1 by 60 MST. Now the main scale that we have chosen, you can see that between the 10 degrees here, between any 10 degrees you take, so between the 10 degrees on the main scale, it is comprised of 20 divisions. So 20 main scale divisions is equivalent to 10 degree. So 1 main scale division will be equal to 10 degree divided by 20. So 10 by 20 is 1.5 or 1/2 degree. So we know that 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. This is equivalent to the clock, where 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So in the angular scale, the hour is replaced by degrees. So half degree is equivalent to half into 60 minute, which is equal to 30 minute. So if we want to calculate the least count, we have to put the value of the 1 MSD. So we had least count is 1 by 60 of MST, and our 1 MSD is 30 minutes. So 60 and 30 cancel out to give a half minute. And if we convert this half minute into seconds, and since 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, so the answer is 30 seconds. So in this way, you can calculate the least count of the spectrometer. Supposingly, you have 41 year scale divisions. So 40 will coincide with 39 main scale division. So least count will be 1 minus of 39 by 40 of MSD. So it will be 1 by 40 MSD. If supposingly now our 30 main scale division is equal to 10 degree. So 1 main scale division will be equal to 1 by 3 of degree. And 1 third of degree will be equal to 1 third of 60 minutes, which is equal to 20 minutes. So we can say that least count will be 1 by 40 into 20 seconds, which is equal to half second. Sorry, it was 20 minutes. So it is half minute, and half minute is again, if you multiply by 60 seconds, so you get an answer of 30 seconds. So here you can see whatever spectrometer you choose, you can calculate the least count accordingly. If there were 10 main scale divisions, 10 main scale division was equivalent to 10 degree, then our 1 main scale division would have been equal to 1 degree. So we would have calculated this, our least count as, so our least count would have been 1 by 40 into 1 degree, which is equal to 1 by 40 into 60 minutes. So this would have been 3 by 2 of minute, and we could further convert it into seconds as 90 seconds. So this would be the least count. So I hope that you have understood how to calculate the least count. There is another way to calculate, and also it is called the shortcut method to calculate the least count. So that shortcut method is just, you have to calculate what is the value of your 1 main scale division. That means you have to calculate your 1 main scale reading, or and you have to divide it by the total number of vernier scale divisions. So if here the 1 main scale reading is what? It is 30 minutes, and the total number of vernier scale divisions were 60. So you get an answer of half minute, which is equal to 30 seconds. And this 30 second is matching with the least count that you calculated using this entire formula. So this is the shortcut way to calculate the least count. And this is not in fact the shortcut way to calculate the least count of only spectrometer. This is the shortcut to calculate the least count of any instrument you are using. Just substitute the value of the 1 main scale division in its units, and you have to put the units also, and you have to divide it by the vernier scale divisions, or you divide it by the circular scale division if you are using a screw gauge. So depending upon the optical instrument you are using, you can calculate the formula of the least count. So I hope that you have understood how to calculate the least count. Meet you again. Thank you.